Rohit Sharma and Mayank Agarwal are all set to break a 47-year-old test record. Between 2015 and 2019, South Africa have lost one World Cup semi-final, one AB de Villiers and all the three test series that they've played in Asia. But they have something up their sleeve. Kya? Janne ke liye dekhte rahein ye stats preview. Hello, my name is Tanay Tiwari and this is the stats preview to the India vs South Africa test series. If Ghar Ke Sher were a cricket team, this current Indian test team would be just that, because since 2013, they've been sitting inside a fortress that has not been breached. The last 10 test series at home, India won all of them. But lo and behold, the nemesis! South Africa's win percentage of 31.25 in India is the best for any visiting side ever. India have had three innings defeats in the last 35 years. All three have come against, yes, South Africa. And yet, those are long gone days, because since 2015, the world has gotten warmer, while South Africa have blown cold. In the 8 tests that they've played in the Asian subcontinent across 3 series, South Africa have not been able to win even one of them. And that is going to be a problem for them. Okay, let's play a game. What's the first thing that comes to your mind when I say the Indian test team? Bumrah, Pujara, Kohli, right? Have you ever thought of the openers? No. And yet, India have tried more openers in the recent past than they've ever before. They've swiped right to more openers than ever before. Since September 2017, India have tried 7 different combinations for their openers with 7 different batsmen. South Africa have had only one, Dean Elgar and Aidan Markram. Barring one game where Markram was injured, but they've been relatively solid in their opening stand. Come the first test, that number 7 will become number 8, because Rohit Sharma will come out to bat in a fresh opening partnership with Mayank Agarwal. I say fresh because, of course, Rohit is opening for the first time in the tests, but also because Mayank has never opened in a home test before this. And this will be the first time in 47 years that India will have a fresh opening pair in a home test. But if there's one man who loves fresh challenges, it has to be Rohitman Sharma. Opening in the limited overs made him the blockbuster player that he is. Will that happen in tests too? He's a seriously good player. In the 9 tests that he has played in India, he averages 85. That is the most for any batsman with 750 plus test runs in India. But against South Africa, his struggles are real. The Proteas have his number in the longest format. Now, away from the batsmen, let's talk about the bowlers. And if you're worried that Jasprit Bumrah is absent, don't worry. Ashwin and Jadeja have been there and done that in home tests for so long that it's not even funny. The last time South Africa came to India, they played 4 tests. To win 4 tests, you must pick 80 wickets. South Africa lost 70, of which 54 were shared between Ashwin and Jadeja. So you do the math. Who were the match winners back then, and who can prove to be the match winners this time around too? 8 more wickets for Ravi Chandran Ashwin and he gets to 350 test wickets. 8 more wickets for Ravi Ashwin in the first test and he gets there as the joint fastest with the legendary Muthaiah Muralidharan. For Ravindra Jadeja, he just has to do what he does every time a visiting team comes. Go after their captain, like he did against Smith, Clark, Cook, Amla, even Du Plessis, who wasn't the captain last time around, struggled to pick Jadeja. This time he's the captain. Chaddu, you know your job. Du Plessis, beware. With 120 World Test Championship points at stake, each test carries 40 points. For India, a series win will mean that they'll extend their lead to 11 successive home series wins, which will be the longest streak in the history. For South Africa, a win here will mean World Test Championship points, form, and also something they lost the last time they came to India. Respect. This series is going to be lit.